In most movies, near the end of the second act, there is one single moment when all hope seems lost. In 2021's Free Guy, it's this moment, when Guy finds out he's a background character in a video game and has an existential crisis. Or wait, is it this moment, 12 minutes later, when the game's servers reboot and Guy is erased? The reason it's not clearly one or the other is because Free Guy is purposely tricking us. In fact, it's hacking the rules of story structure. And when you understand why, you'll realize this trick might be the secret to Free Guy's success. So let's talk about how they broke the rules and why. This is Unstructured by Plotwell. Let's start with a quick recap of the movie. Free Guy follows Guy, a non-player character in an open-world video game, as he gains sentience and tries to save his world from being erased. He works together with Millie, a real-world coder who is trying to prove that the makers of the video game stole her code. So the story is about two things: Guy saving his world and Millie uncovering her code. Remember these because they'll be important later. But to understand how Free Guy is hacking story structure, we'll need to cover some story structure first. Remember that moment we mentioned earlier when all hope seems lost? That's something we call the moment of peril. It's in most movies, especially popular ones. Here's Shrek, the 2001 animated classic when Shrek and Fiona argue and Fiona agrees to marry Farquaad. All hope certainly seems lost. The moment of peril is followed by two other moments, Rock Bottom and the Inner Gateway. Rock Bottom is a moping period, like this montage in Shrek where we wallow in the awfulness. And the Inner Gateway is when the main character has an epiphany and recommits to their goal, like when Shrek realizes he needs to profess his love to Fiona and flies with Donkey to interrupt the wedding. This whole section is important for many reasons, but one in particular. It shows the main character's grit and commitment to their goal. Even when the task seems impossible and they're trapped in a bathroom with feet full of glass, they keep on fighting. It's why we root so hard for the hero, because after watching what they've gone through, we believe they deserve to win. In a way, it humanizes the character, letting us see them at their most vulnerable. But in Free Guy, this section happens twice. First, in the moment of peril, Millie tells Guy he's a background character and his actions don't matter. Guy spends his rock bottom hucking, you guessed it, literal rocks through the edge of his world and screaming in the streets. And in the Inner Gateway, Guy talks to Buddy, who helps him realize his actions do matter, even if he's just an NPC. Then, in the second moment of peril, the game's servers get rebooted. The second rock bottom shows Guy has forgotten who Millie is and won't be able to help her. But in the second Inner Gateway, Millie kisses Guy, re-sparking his memories and bringing Guy back. You might think this section happens twice because there are two main characters, Guy and Millie. But that's not exactly correct. Lots of movies have multiple main characters and only one of these sections, and it usually happens in one of two ways. If both main characters are working together to get to the same thing, like in the SpongeBob SquarePants movie, which we covered in a previous video, they can essentially be treated as one character with one goal, so only one section is needed to show their failure, wallowing, and recommitment. If the two main characters have different goals, like in Tangled, where Rapunzel wants to be free from her tower and Flynn wants his satchel back, the moment of peril is usually one moment that halts both their goals. In this case, Flynn is captured and Rapunzel is brought back home. In these cases, the rock bottoms and inner gateways are usually shown in succession, like how Rapunzel and Flynn realize back-to-back that Gothel was the villain all along. And both of these realizations are less than a minute apart. So why does Free Guy separate its two sections by 12 minutes? To understand, let's revisit something we mentioned earlier. Remember this? So the story is about two things: Guy saving his world and Millie uncovering her code. Just like in Tangled, the two main characters have different goals. Guy is trying to stop his world from ending, and Millie is trying to find her code before it does. So each of these storylines should have a section where things seem hopeless. Normally, this would be double-dipped. For example, the movie could have banned Millie from the game, stopping her from finding her code and from helping Guy save his world. All hope would certainly seem lost. But instead, the movie did something extremely clever. Remember the context. Guy is a non-player character. He is, by definition, inhuman. So what better way to humanize him than to give him his own section? To show him fighting when all signs point to giving up. Instead of lumping Guy into Millie's story, Free Guy emphasizes Guy's section separately, and thus emphasizes what the story is truly about. A non-player character becoming, well, a player character. A way to show Guy becoming sentient by playing with the very idea of stories themselves. So even though Free Guy broke the rules by doubling its moment of peril, Rock Bottom, and Inner Gateway, it did so for a clever reason. By giving Guy his own section, the movie helped humanize an inhuman character. And instead of lumping Guy's section in with Millie's, the movie separated them, emphasizing the theme of the story and helping us root for Guy. Because once you understand how stories work, you'll realize how well Free Guy tricked us. And we fell for it perfectly.
That building! That's fake! This street! It's fake! That car!